Association of Alberta, and later worked with the Slave Lake Community Action Group. During the 1970s and 80s, she worked with Northern Alberta communities creating relevant social change with a focus on education and community development initiatives. She was the first Métis woman appointed to the University of Alberta Senate and was a founding member of the Métis Women's Council of Edmonton and co-chaired the Alberta Métis Elders Senate. She also chaired the National Métis Senate Commission, Constitutional Commission, where a draft government structure was developed for the Métis Nation of Canada. In 1997, she became the first Aboriginal woman appointed to the Senate of Canada, where she acted as chair of the Senate Standing Committee on Aboriginal Peoples and commissioned several studies regarding Aboriginal issues. Retired from the Senate in 2004, she is the founder and patron of Najif Cultural and Resource Institute. Ladies and gentlemen, please turn your attention to the screens.
I thought we were kind of normal, but as I grew older, I realized that we were kind of a little different, but very much a family unit, and everybody called her mom. My friends called her mom. She's that kind of person. So very much a family unit working together to help her, because she was a single woman. And so she always had that independent drive. She always wanted to make the community better. She always has other people in her heart, and she's thinking about those other people. It was never about her. It was always about the community and what she could do for the community and help enrich the community. One of the amazing things is that I always say I went to the University of Thelma, because she brought us to all of those Métis assemblies, meetings at the Friendship Center. And so really it was my education, and I share that today with people. Besides raising all of us to be pretty decent people, I think for me it was when she got appointed to the Senate. That, you know, it brings tears to my eyes even just thinking about it. It was such an accomplishment, such a compliment to her, you know. But it was because of her community work, and she was recognized because of that. My mother has over 30 grandchildren and almost as many great-grandchildren. And about 10 years ago, a number of us got together. And my oldest niece, who was part of the Latter-day Saints, did our family genealogy. That's very important for Métis people. And so for us to see all of that work and to see where we come from and be introduced to Blanche of Castile. And when you read about Blanche of Castile, you read about Thelma Chalifoux. If she could physically and mentally, she would be out there working. She has just started to realize that she can't. She said that they threw her out of the Senate. It's a mandatory retirement in 75, and she said they can't do it. It's been a ride with her, and we're still on that ride, and it's just been so much fun. And it really is the University of Thelma. I work in a museum, and it's because of her and her teachings that I teach what I teach.
Wow, she's amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the City of Edmonton's new.